as Descon, we are a pretty diversified company. But here in Qatar, where we are working for last more than 10 years, we are mostly focusing on plant services and maintenance and electromechanical construction. So in the near future, not so many projects of electromechanical construction is coming up, except very few, like there is Qatar refineries expansion, and there is a dolphin. I would say that they are adding a couple of more compressors. So now we are focusing more on the infrastructure side. On the other hand, we are focusing the traditional plant services business. And plant services, I would consider that still we are, in my opinion, we are leading the market. Of course, not with a major margin, but we are quite confident that in the next year we will secure major shutdowns, and we will be able to get a further edge in the plant services and shutdowns. Entering into infrastructure business is a major change for Descon Qatar, not for Descon, because Descon, Descon as a company is operating in many Gulf areas like Abu Dhabi, Saudi Arabia, Kuwait, and of course in Pakistan. So this infrastructure is not a new thing, but for our region, for our country, Qatar, this is a new thing. The good thing is that we have a lot of expertise. The difficult thing is that we are not so much familiar with the quality requirement and the specific, the area specific requirement in Qatar. So maybe we are thinking to go in some kind of JV arrangement with some more reputable company, some Western company. Maybe initially we will lose little money, or maybe we'll not be able to make profit. But definitely this is the only way to move forward. Challenges are there, but business is nothing but taking some risk, and that's all. For the construction companies, the major challenge is competition is increasing, and it's not very easy to cope with the increasing competition. Although the global recession has reduced the cost of human resource to some extent, but the increasing competition, will not be very easy to cope for the companies, because companies are coming from all across. It looks that the only area where construction is being done is Qatar, which may not be precisely true, but the focus is Qatar. So this is the biggest challenge. Then definitely with so many infrastructural activities taking place in this country, and the size of countries is small, there is already very logistic problem, traffic jam, you can't move, and so many roads are coming up, so many flyovers are coming. So definitely that will create a serious problem of logistic type, and commute from one area to other may become difficult. I would say that either UAE is slightly slowing down. They are also cutting their budgets and all those kind of things. Saudi Arabia is very stable. I don't think there is any decline, but Qatar is going up. Unfortunately, not in that specific part of business, which we call the oil and gas electromechanical, but overall as a country. So Qatar is the fastest growing economy, but Qatar has their own challenges also, because the pace of progress which Qatar is witnessing now, that required their own infrastructure, on the state level, because billions and billions of dollars of activities, you know, ultimately government is controlling. And government's nominated departments, they are controlling. So they have to look into. Anyhow, Qatar is different by the pace of progress, pace of development. Qatar is maybe different, that Qatar is always look for something very unique. Like if the building should be unique, and this is unique. So which is good, which I like, of course, and they can afford, so they can desire such kind of thing. But the pace is very fast comparing to other country. The targets are very clear, which Qatar government has. Qatar is focusing more on education, and particularly education of women. So that is, I spent 4 or 5 years also in Saudi Arabia, that I could not find there. Of course, they spend a lot of money on education. But the way they are spending money on education, I mean, that is something that they really want, that this nation become highly educated. And particularly when they focus their women, that is something which I really admire, because if you educate your women, mean you are educating the whole nation, and that is something very long term. An educated man may be a short term benefit, but educated woman is a long term benefit which you are getting. So this is another difference which I noticed here.